Hello, what is up? Thank you for joining me here today. My name is Jamie, and today we're going to review the new 13-inch MacBook Pro. I just got this in the post today. I was waiting eagerly for it by the door. Let's jump straight into it. Just looking at the box, it's got the picture of the MacBook Pro, just a side profile on the front. And then if you flip it over on the back, it's just got the 13-inch MacBook Pro. And then the more nitty-gritty specs about this. 13.3 inches on the screen, 16 gig of RAM. I think that's quad core, but I will check it later. And then kind of figured myself further down the line, if I do want to upgrade that RAM again, I will upgrade it to 32 myself. Upgrading the processor, the CPU, is something that you can't do yourself. As far as I understand, you can upgrade the RAM and the ROM, like the hard drive capacity, but you cannot upgrade the processor. I just got the standard 512 gig hard drive. That's the lowest one that you can get. I kind of figured I'm going to be using portable hard drives anyways. Like, there's no way I would ever keep all of my footage on my Mac. And then, yeah, it's just got a British keyboard. I'll talk a little bit more about the keyboard when I get this open, because there's been a lot of change and a lot of things that Apple have done to make this keyboard, or rather regenerate this keyboard from an older model. So, just looking at the wrapping, the packaging. First thing I notice is this is new. The big tab here, that was never on the old boxes. As far as I remember, with the old boxes, you used to kind of like get your finger here, like in the groove, and like score around. Yeah, who remembers that on Christmas Day when they're a kid? But they've kind of now made this like nice, easy tab, and I've been wanting to pull this ever since it came through the door. So let's give this a go. Oh yeah, that's a good feeling. Yeah, let's get all this off now. Okay, so the outside of the box feels pretty similar to the old MacBooks. And to be honest, I think Apple have always led the market on their quality of box. It's not a big thing, but I do think it's a really, really cool little addition. I was actually speaking to a guy in a Apple shop a few years ago, and he told me how much design goes into how to design the box so that slowly slides out at the optimal rate. So let's give it a go. Quite slow. There we go. So yeah. There it is. Just got this little tab here that you pick up. And if I'm not mistaken, Apple have started to go for alternatives to straight up plastic for all of this wrapping paper, which is good to hear. I imagine there's a lot of these get sold. It's every little bit for the environment. In the box, what you get is you get all your sort of paperwork and your documentation, pretty standard. And then you get your plug. This is obviously a British plug. And you get, now from my knowledge, this is a 2 meter sort of charger cable that is USB-C to USB-C. Now I know that that's not a new thing with this model, they did it on the previous model, but the model before that, I think was the old charging end, which I can't remember the name of that, but yeah, the new one's USB-C. And that's pretty much it for inside the box. The one thing I'm disappointed to see, and I know that again, this isn't a new thing with the new models, but that you don't get, do you remember with the old Macs? I think I've got my charger here. With the old Macs, you got the 2 meter charger cable, the thin bit, and then you got another 2 meters of thick bit. That thick bit saves my life, because I feel like I'm handcuffed to a plug in the wall when I've only got 2 meters. It's like on your iPhone when you're trying to sit in bed and you're like, ugh. Yeah, I don't like that. So what I will be doing with this Mac, and you might be able to do with yourself, is I'm going to take the thick bit off my old Mac and I'm going to put it onto my new one, so that my charger is then essentially the same length as my old one. Okay, so let's get on to the Mac itself. So this big pull tab, very satisfying. I think like all of the stuff that they designed with all the plastic, when you take it off, it's all pretty satisfying. Okay, so This is the model with four USB-C ports, and on the right-hand side you get your two USB-C ports and a 3.5mm headphone jack. And on the other side you just get your two other USB-C ports. And that's pretty much it. Like with the model before this, but not the model before that, they've ditched the card reader, which as a video editor myself is gonna be a pain. There are sort of workarounds that people are using, and I'll talk about that a little bit later. But yeah, I would have quite liked to have seen the sort of native video card reader. But anyways, it's pretty light. It's pretty, feels pretty thin. It is thicker than the Air. I don't have an Air to show you. But what I do have to show you is the model before. This is the new model, and this is the old model, and there's very, very little in that. Like, if I run my finger, there's a bit of a ridge there, so it is a little bit thicker. This is a MacBook Pro, this is a MacBook. But yeah, they are essentially the exact same. The difference is that with the MacBook Pro, or at least this spec one that I've got, you get your extra USB-C ports, or at least I paid for the extra two. I think it's an option. I think you can't, don't quote me on this, but I think you can get a one with two USB-C ports and pay a bit less. Just going back to the whole USB-C port thing and two ports versus four ports, and the fact that they've changed from USB in general to USB-C. This is sort of the solution that's being offered up at the moment, and it's a USB-C port hub. And you can get them with all different kinds of inputs. I think this one's like a 7-way one. So that is something that you can sort of plug into USB-C, and then you instantly get a card reader, an HDMI slot, and the three USB slots. I think it's gonna be an option that I look into. Just personally, like, I still use USB on a lot of my hard drives. I have now bought a USB-C cable hard drive, but it's still coming from Amazon. So for the minute, I will be using this. The only issue with some of these is that you have to watch out when you're buying them, is that quite a lot of them don't transfer power from the MacBook through the USB ports. So you can't charge things off them. And if your hard drive uses power to power up and function, it's not gonna work. So when you're buying these, make sure the main thing, if you need to use a hard drive that takes power, is you get a power transfer USB-C port hub. The only other option that you can go with is these, which I bought. Which do power transfer power. They're basically just USB to USB-C converters. So that's my sort of temporary fix at the minute, along with this hub. Until I kind of work out what I'm doing. This technology is so new. Apple are sort of the first ones to sort of fully commit, fully jump ship from USB and kind of get rid of all USB ports. So it's something that I'm gonna start having to catch up on if I don't wanna always constantly use a converter. Okay, so let's get this bad boy open. That's a really, really nice touch. As soon as you open it, it just powers on. And it's powering on pretty quick. It feels like it is compared to my old one. So yeah, you don't even take the sort of, whatever the new material, biodegradable material is, you don't even sort of take that off. And you just open it and it just powers up. Really, really cool. I like that, Apple. So just looking at the inside, got the sort of touch bar here. Then there's the finger reader here in the top corner, but you've still got your speaker up each left hand and right hand side of the keyboard. As far as I know, I think it's the brow or whatever it's called around here, the chin or something like that, I don't know. Where the metal part around the keyboard, that has been reduced in size so that the keyboard can be increased in size. Like, everything's sort of been compacted more into this. In the old model, this model, Apple placed in, it was a new keyboard for this model, and it was like a low pro keyboard. You can just feel the keys, but like, they're a lot lower pro, they're a lot less pronounced than maybe, I don't know, for example, this is my old MacBook, and the keys on this are like really, really, really pronounced, and when you run your fingers over them, you can sort of hear that, like, whereas on the slightly newer model, but not the newest model, it's a lot lower pro and you can't hear it as much. I kind of understand why they wanted to do that, but like, see using this and using my old one, I much prefer the standout keys. Like when you hit them, you know you've hit them. When Apple released this butterfly keyboard, they kind of said it's lower profile, but you still feel like you're typing. You still get that click, that responsiveness out of each click. But you know, like, I don't think you do. That's just my opinion. I was actually chatting to my girlfriend about this last night, and she loves this keyboard. Like, she thinks she gets just as much responsiveness. She actually prefers it. So I guess it's just personal preference. But what's ended up happening is these keyboards have got a mechanism called a scissor mechanism inside, and it's the type of spring that gives you that sort of feedback once you've, like, in responsiveness, once you've tapped each key. Those springs have been failing quite a lot. Apple have actually, for once, or very rarely, listened to the community and went back to the old type keyboard. What you need to know is, no longer is there a sort of low profile keyboard. You've now got the more defined keyboard again. It definitely is more, like, pronounced. So I'm happy about that. I do like it. Like I said, I prefer the sort of more embossed keyboard. It's nice. It's a nice touch. Thanks, Apple. The Touch ID is the power button on this one. So it's just there where the power button sort of used to be on, like, on the old models, but it doesn't have a power sign on. And as far as I understand, without powering this up and kind of going into it, it's how you log on. I don't know if that can be overridden with a password. I know some people are kind of a bit weird about, like, fingerprints and things being, like, quite easy to counterfeit anything, and people being able to access your laptop and whatever. I think overall, like, I really, really like it. I'm really excited about it. I got the space gray, by the way. You can get this, and you can get it in the old color, like just the normal brush silver. But yeah, I thought I'd go for something a bit different. Overall, it's really, really cool. This isn't a sort of comprehensive review because I've literally just got it out of the box. If I can give one positive and one negative, I think my negative's going to be the fact that I have to go with the USB-C, like, that it's totally eradicated USB. I know that that's a problem that isn't new to this model. Like I said, it came on the old model as well. But yeah, positive, I think Apple have done really, really well to listen to the community and go back to the original keyboard. Like, I think that's really good. It shows that Apple are listening. It shows that they still want to diversify and keep up market leaders. So if you like this video, I plan on making more unboxing videos. Leave your comments down below if you got this and you feel like I missed anything out, or you feel like you've got a different perspective on things. It'd be really good to hear from you. And please hit that like and subscribe button, and stay tuned for more. Cheers.